It's your boy St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. Today we're checking out Goldbaby's Fatso Synths Volume 1. Goldbaby has been well known for his drums and his processing that he does to them, analog and vintage and tape and all that stuff. But now he's been messing around with some making some instruments for Kontakt and EXS. So we're checking out the Fatso Synths Volume 1. It's the Moog MG1, the Korg Delta, the Roland JX3P, Insoni ESQ1 and the Yamaha DX100 ran through the Fatso. It's actually a modded version, the UBK Fatso, that has some special compression settings and stuff on it. Basically, the Fatso is like a something that thickens up your sound, adds some harmonics, gives it a tape saturation type of feel or whatever. So I'm using the Kontakt version. So basically, I'm going to just go through a bunch of the sounds and kind of show you what they sound like with his special thing. So let's check it out. As you can see, you got drums, you get mono, poly, raw oscillators, raw sounds, and then single cycle oscillators. And that's pretty much it. So we're going to start with this delta bass lead and then just go from there. All right, so let's see. Here's the bass lead. So you can hear the character. And he's done some mod wheel settings, so you can get some expression. He's also sounds like he's done some velocity scripting as well. So it's nice to have the mod wheel in there, not just static sounds. And you got the instrument names before the sound, so. So the LFO synth, DX100. Alright, let's check out one of the ESQs, check out the sharpshooter. That sounds like. You could definitely hear the character. One thing I always notice about samples of synths as opposed to actual VSTs is a lot of times when you sample the synths, there's a certain character to them that you can't get with the emulation. Not that emulations aren't good, but there's just a little something extra that comes with the samples from a classic synth or whatever. So. And also, they don't use a bunch of CPU, which is always good. Let's check out one of these Moog. Let's check out this Moog sub, see what that sounds like. That's a fat bass right there, man. Alright, let's look at some of these polyphonic ones. Let's check out this CPU hog synth. So, we've got some scripting going on in that. Single cycle poly. So you can hear definitely a nice character, playable sounds, expressive because of the scripting that he's done. And they definitely got a fat sound to it. Check this out. Our mod wheel settings in there. Check out this pad. Rolling. Piano. It's cute. Not bad, not bad. That one takes up a little bit more. CPU must got some a bunch of scripting going on. Let's check out these strings. Alright, let's look at these raw oscillators. If you want to build your own sounds or you just like the sound of the oscillators. Some delta oscillator. SX100 oscillators. These ESQ oscillators. Definitely some fat waves. Let's look at one of these Moog leads or one of these Moog oscillators. What do they sound like? I like that. I want to hear this Moog square. Nice. Let's count some of these raw sounds. Delta. Not bad. It's a click organ. DX100. There's a synth. I really like the programming on them. Keeps everything playable and expressive, and it just adds to the character of the sounds. Nice little ESQ bell. Let's see what's up with that. If you like that sound, stick to it. That's all. That's a pretty thick lead right there. Then here's some single cycle oscillators. I don't know about you, but I like that. It's nice. Do that. Deep bass with that. And there's another Moog. So yeah, man, as you can see, it's got a lot of character. I really like the sound of it. I like how it's programmed. I like how he put the modulation in there and did some other scripting to get expressive, so it's not just static samples. Sounds like there's some stuff that responds to velocity as well as the mod wheel, so it might be some effects in there and stuff too. But they load fast, they're not big, huge samples. They're good on the CPU depending on how much scripting is going on. And like I said, there's just something about samples from classic synths opposed to VSTs, which is a different sound. So yeah, check it out. I like it. It's your boy St. Joe, SoundsAndGear.com. Checking out Goldbaby Fatso Synths Volume 1. I give it a 4 out of 5 subs. Definitely worth checking out if you want a different sound than the normal VSTs that come around. So yeah, check it out. Let me know what you think. Holla at y'all later. SoundsAndGear.com.